There's another type of problem you're going to find in this homework assignment, and that is a situation where your quadratic is already given in general notation. Okay, now for these type, I strongly suggest that you use the negative b over 2a to find the x-coordinate of the vertex. Okay, now a is positive 1, so that means this is going to open upwards. That's going to be useful to us. That will determine that the vertex is a minimum. So let's go ahead and use negative b over 2a, and we find this x-coordinate of the vertex is equal to 2. That is also x equal 2 will be the equation for the axis of symmetry. Okay, we're going to need this x equal 2 quite a bit. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to plug this into our original function and get the y coordinate that corresponds to that x equal 2. And that will be a y equal 2. All right, so our axis of symmetry then is x equal 2, and our vertex is 2 comma 2. Okay, let's find out some more stuff to help us plot this thing. Let's talk about our y-intercept. That's pretty easy. That's just going to mean the x-coordinate is 0, and let's find the y-coordinate. All right, so when the x-coordinate is 0, my function tells me the y-coordinate is 6. Okay, so I've got two good points to plot on my function. Okay, now let's try to find the x-intercept. So we're going to see on this problem, not so simple. Okay, so x-intercepts means I need to find the values of x where y is 0. In other words, what values of x will make this function 0? And here's my problem. Factoring this is not going to be pretty. I can do it by completing the square, but there's a method that is just as effective. What we're going to do is we're going to use the quadratic equation. Okay, so a is equal to 1, b is equal to negative 4, c is equal to negative 6. So we plug this into our quadratic formula. We're very careful about our signs, and this is what we get. Okay, now here's an issue right there. I've got a negative 8 in the numerator. What am I going to do with that negative 8? Well, I can factor that to negative 1 times 4 times 2, all under a radical. Okay, now I can do a little bit of simplification. The negative 1 becomes I, the square root of 4 becomes 2, and now I'm at this place. Now I have to be careful how I simplify. Oftentimes students want to take the 2 and divide it into 2 in the radical. I can't do that. But what I can do is, if it's outside the radical, all these terms can be legitimately divided by 2. So I've got a simplification of 2 plus or minus imaginary I times the square root of 2. So that means I have two answers for x. If I plug 2 plus I square root of 2 in the original function, it will equal 0. If I plug in 2 minus I root 2 into the original function, it will equal 0. So these are my x coordinates that will give me y equals 0. Okay, we're ready to graph. Okay, let's start with our vertex. Simple enough. Let's throw in our axis of symmetry, which is just the x-coordinate of the vertex. Let's throw in my y-intercept. Those are kind of the no-brainers. That's pretty easy. Okay, we're going to use the fact that I am symmetrical about the axis of symmetry. It means I'm going to have another point that is an equal distance from my line of symmetry. That's what symmetry means. And while we're at it, talking about symmetry, I can decide if this function is even, odd, or neither. Now be careful. Yes, it is symmetrical, but it's not symmetrical about the y-axis, so it's neither. Okay, so we know what the parent function is, so we can use our MAD parent function skills for quadratic, fill in a few more points. Okay, now let's talk about these pesky x-intercepts. I think when you fill this in, we said it opened upward, we can see it doesn't cross the x-axis, only in our imagination. That's why our x-intercepts turn out to be imaginary numbers. So these are the coordinates of our x-intercept. They're imaginary numbers. And when I have an imaginary number with a real number, we call these complex numbers. And I can fill in my graph and I can see it indeed does not cross the x-axis. So I've done everything the problem has asked me to do. I've graphed it, I've found the x-intercepts, y-intercepts, axis of symmetry, and the vertex. And that concludes this problem.